Hello, welcome to Conversations About the Person of the Holy Spirit. You know, you might ask, why is she excited today? I get excited every time that I have the opportunity to talk about this sweet person that has made my life ever so beautiful, irrespective of everything that I've been up against. You know, it's such a sweet thing to know that God has not left us alone. God did not leave us alone, and God will not leave us alone. It's His promise. You know, He says that I will guide you in the best pathway for your life. And the Holy Spirit is this amazing person that leads us, guides us, more so escorts us on our journey in life. Today, I'll be speaking on the topic signed, sealed, and delivered. And before I go on, my name is Bimbomi Sili, and I'm the host on Conversations About the Person of the Holy Ghost. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 14 tells us clearly that the Holy Spirit is God's guarantee, you know, that we will receive the inheritance and that we have been bought, that we are His own. The minute you gave your life to Christ, the minute you confessed Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you became His own. And guess what? You were actually God's own, all of it, you know, ever since. Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 5, it says, before I formed you, I knew you, and I ordained you a prophet. God has a plan for your life. And working in the accomplishment of this plan, working in the fulfillment of this plan, comes from knowing that you're His first of all. Now, the Holy Spirit is that person that God has given to show us that, hey, this one has been bought. This one has been paid for. And every day of our lives, God wants us to walk conscious of the fact that we belong to Him and that He has a wonderful plan for our lives. You know, I like to give a simple example about children, you know, who are fathers. They really do not have to think about how will my next school fees be paid? How am I going to fend for myself? Why? Because they have the assurance that they have a father who has it all figured out. And this is what God wants you to know, that He has a beautiful plan for your life and He has it all figured out. And this should affect the way that you talk to God. This should affect the way that you approach your Father. Sometimes the reason people don't get answers to their request is because just before they are talking to God, the devil is already raining accusations. Oh, you're not qualified to talk to God. You're not worthy to talk to God. Look at what you did yesterday. You're not even qualified. You did something bad. Oh, see the thoughts that came to your heart right in church. The devil is always bringing these accusations before us. But God says to us to come boldly. You know, God wants us to approach His presence, knowing that He is our Father. You would hardly find a child who knows that his father loves him, you know, go to his father trembling and say, please, daddy, would you give us breakfast today? Please, daddy, would you pay? I'm sorry for what I did. Please pay my school fees. No. If as earthly parents or as earthly fathers, we will not do that. Or if your earthly father will not do that to you, why do you think God will do that to you? Jesus paid the price. Jesus became sin. It says, for God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever, anyone who believes in Him will not perish, but have eternal life. You know, the Bible shows us clearly that whilst we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. This is so much love displayed to us. This is so much love shown to us. Whilst we were yet sinners, whilst we were in sin, God had a plan already for us. He sent Jesus and He died for us. And the Bible shows us clearly that if He did not withhold His Son Jesus, how much more shall He give us all things, together with Him, give us all things. I want you today to rise in the consciousness of your righteousness in Christ. Jesus became sin. He took your place that you may become the righteousness. And if you have confessed Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you are. It's not something that you work for. It's something that you should be conscious of. And this should guide, you know, the way that you talk to God. You should go boldly to God and talk to Him. If you've gone wrong, you know that the things that you have done that is no, simply apologize. Say to Him, I'm sorry, and mean it from your heart and move on. You know, God wants you to lay hold on all that He has for you. The Holy Spirit is the seal, the guarantee that God has paid for us, the guarantee that we belong to Christ, to God. And if we belong to God, He has amazing plans for us. Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11 says, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, they are thoughts of good and not of evil, to give you a hope and a future." God has amazing plans for you. And the Holy Spirit is the one who will take you from one place to another, revealing the plan of the Father to you. 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 9 to 10. It says, "Eyes have not seen, ears has not heard, it hasn't entered the imagination of any man, the plans that God has for us." But verse 10 says, "But we know the Spirit of God is the one who reveals these plans for us, to us." Sometimes He reveals the big picture because God deals in big things. God doesn't do small things. If God gave you a small dream, then maybe you won't need it. If someone gave me today, you know, I've since gone past school. If someone gave me today a promise to work, you know, a year to work, I'm not going to be praying about it. I could close my eyes to answer the questions. So God shows us big things. God shows us massive things that He wants us to do. But on a daily basis, the Holy Spirit leads us from one place to another in absolute victory. It leads us from one place to another, unfolding God's plan for us. God's plan daily, God's plan weekly, God's plan. And He shows us from one level to another what He wants us to do. God has amazing plans for you. Don't let the devil shut you down. Don't let the devil cut you short. Don't let the devil bring thoughts of you're not worthy. God qualified you. You have been signed, sealed by the Holy Ghost for an amazing work on earth. Philippians 2 verse 10 says that for God is at work in us, both to do, both to will and to do of His good pleasure. The Amplified Translation says that God is at work in us. The Amplified Translation speaks about, you know, God is the one who creates the desire in us to do the good works that He planned for us and to live the good life. There is a good work that God has planned for you, and there is a good life. Don't let the devil cheat you out of it. Don't let the devil bring thoughts of unworthiness. Jesus took your place. It became sin that you may become the righteousness of God in Him. And whenever you go wrong, you don't just go before your Father and just say, "I'm sorry," and you go on. And when the devil brings up that accusation, say to him, "Hey, this is between father and daughter. Get thee behind me." You know, I need you today to rise in the consciousness of your righteousness. Don't try to merit the favor of God. Don't think it's your fasting. You know, if I fast enough, God will hear me. No. The Bible even shows us clearly that before we call, He has heard us. Whilst we are yet speaking, the answer has come. Jeremiah 33:33, God gives us an invitation. "Call unto me and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things." If He wasn't going to show us, He wouldn't ask us to call. Today I need you to rise in the consciousness of what Jesus has done for you. The Holy Spirit is the guarantee, you know, that you have been bought with a price. The Holy Spirit is a guarantee that you have been purchased. Rise in the consciousness of this. God is no more angry with you. God is not looking for, you know, He's not looking for ways to nail you. No. You know, 1,000 times no. The story of the prodigal son shows us clearly, you know, how that the son had gone, taken all of his inheritance, gone out, spent it, you know, unwisely. And at the, you know, at the sight of the child, the father was the one who ran towards the child. This is the love of God towards us. Before we even showed up, He sent Jesus to pay such huge sacrifice for us. Today, rise in the consciousness of your righteousness in Christ Jesus. You're not righteous by your own, but in Christ Jesus is made you righteous. And I want you to rise in the consciousness of this. God is not withholding anything from you. God is not saying you need to fast more to merit this. Jesus took your place. Jesus did it all. Rise in the consciousness of this. And the Holy Spirit is the one, as you read the scripture, is going to point your direction, you know, to the different things that Jesus brought for you. You know, the Bible shows us clearly that all scripture is inspired. You know, God moved up, the Holy Ghost moved upon people to write the scripture. And this scripture is for our sake. Today, take time out to meditate on the Word of God. This will help you grow in your consciousness of your righteousness in Christ Jesus. Meditate on God's Word. If there's an area of your life where, you know, maybe your health, you're having challenges in your health, you have bills unpaid, you're making wrong decisions, get into the Word. There is a particular Word for every area of your life. And as you pray, just talk to the Holy Ghost. Show me what to do about my marriage, about my finances, about my business. And as you start to meditate, get scriptures concerning that area of your life. It will bless you a great deal. Don't let the devil, you know, just cheat you from all that Jesus has paid for you. No. Even the Bible shows us clearly, there is no one who is not, anyone who is not sick does not require a doctor. Jesus paid so that we might have life and have it in abundance. The thief comes, John 10:10, to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And the way he steals from people is he just rubs them off and just tells them, you're not worthy, see what you did. And some people have gone, some people just live in their past mistakes. Maybe you aborted a child when you're in secondary school. Now you've even married, you've gone past it. And the devil just keeps bringing, oh, this is why you're not pregnant. Remember what you did? No. If any man be in Christ, is a new creature. In fact, even if it was after you gave your heart to Christ that happened, it's gone now. You can receive forgiveness and forget it. And the next time the devil brings it, rise in your authority and rebuke him. There is so much that God has in store for you. 2020 is not over. God crowns the year with fatness. That's what Psalms tells us. Don't let the devil cheat you of all that God has, all that Jesus has paid for you. The Holy Ghost, as you take time out in scripture, the Holy Ghost will begin to show you and begin to speak them forth over your life. God has given you life and life in abundance. Not just life in your health, but life in your family. If you have a family, or you know someone who is almost at the verge of divorce, that's not God's plan. That's not God's plan. You can arise and receive all that God has in store for you. There is so much that this year still has to offer. Don't let the devil put you in the place that you're not worthy. Oh, the reason this happened is because you're a sinner. And you then start to compare yourself. Oh, really? And if you allow this thought settle, you will just, you know, be getting yourself, the devil is just going to deny you of more and more that you should have received in Christ Jesus. Today, what's the topic again? Signed, sealed, and delivered. God has brought you out of darkness into his marvelous light. You're no longer the same person. Rise in the consciousness of your righteousness today. Hallelujah. 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 Would you just lift your hands where you are and let's just thank God. That's how it starts. And as you thank God, just say, thank you, Father, for I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Thank you, Father, for you paid the price for me. Thank you, Father. And if you've not given your heart to Jesus, this is the time to do it. In fact, if there's anyone the devil is going to bring such accusation against, it is the one who hasn't even confessed Jesus as his Lord and Savior. Quickly, would you say this prayer after me? You want to make Jesus your Lord and your Savior so that you can witness this eternal life. You can be signed, sealed, and delivered. It's so simple. Just believe in your heart, Jesus, and confess his Lord over your life. Would you pray this prayer after me? I mean it from your heart. Dear Father, thank you for sending Jesus to die for me. I believe that Jesus is the Son of God. I believe that he died and he rose on the third day for my sake. And today I confess that Jesus is Lord over my life. I receive eternal life. And I declare today that I am born again. Thank you, Father, for accepting me. In Jesus' name, amen. If you said that prayer, I would love to hear from you. Send me an email, bimbo@bimbomissily.com. I'd love to hear from you. And if you're already born again, I need you to rise in the consciousness. One of the ways to do this is when the devil brings thoughts to you, don't try to quieten that thought with another thought. No, shut down that thought with your words. Don't be quiet about it. If you have asked for forgiveness, if you asked God for forgiveness, why do you think he won't forgive you? Absolutely. The minute you said it, it forgave you. But you need to rise in the consciousness of this. So the next time the devil comes knocking, at the door of your hearts, rebuke him and begin to declare, I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Maybe you are still even dealing with an addiction. You know, you're falling here and there, and then you say, I'm not going to do this again. And then it happens. You can rise today and confess, sin shall no longer have dominion over me. I've been bought with a price. I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Remember, with the heart man believes, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. This scripture doesn't just apply to when you give your heart to Jesus, but continuous. You know, salvation is from soteria, and it's all around. Salvation in your health, salvation in your business. God wants it to be all around. And so you keep believing in your heart and confessing, I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Even when you're dealing with an habit, keep declaring it. I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. It says we've been bought with a price. Hallelujah. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9 says, you're a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, the holy nation, a peculiar people. We've been brought out of darkness into his marvelous light. In light there is life. In light there is no shadow of darkness. And the devil dwells, you know, in darkness. Just putting in those thoughts in your heart. You're not worthy. Jesus made you worthy. Jesus made you worthy. And I'm so glad that this has been a blessing to you. Now my book is out and I'm so excited about it. I have a new book talking about the person of the Holy Spirit. This book is available and it will bless you. You that you just gave your heart to Christ, I think you're the first person who should get this book. I explain in details about who this person is and how you can fellowship with him daily, how you can enjoy his ministry. And in fact, this topic that I just taught is the first chapter. You are mine. That's what chapter 1 says. Explaining how Jesus, and I put in those books stories that you can relate to it, that will help you walk in a daily life of victory. Thank you for connecting to conversations about the person of the Holy Spirit. And I come your way again next week. Keep maximizing the ministry of the Holy Spirit. God bless you.